It's cold and it's almost Christmas, so it's time to do another layout update. So for the first part of the layout update, I'm going to go ahead and give you a brief overview of some of the stuff that I've added to the layout and some of the stuff that I've gotten for it. So let's start out with some of the new things I got. Definitely not these giant buildings that are helping with the layout. Starting off, no, I'm just kidding. These three buildings that I got were from my mom's friend, and she gave them to me to put up on the layout since it's Christmas time, and she thought they would fit in pretty well. They are pretty big, but they obstruct the view of this unfinished area, and so they actually work very well. Even though they are big, it actually really makes it look like a big city if you're down on the ground level right here. And you could, if you put some cars in here, I got this while I was in Vegas, it fits in really well. So you can see that it obstructs that, and it looks nice, and it really solidifies its place on the layout. Now, moving on to these new pieces of rolling stock that I've gotten. I actually just finished episode 2 of Train Show Finds. Some of the channel OGs, if that's what you call it. If you remember that series from 5 years ago almost, I've decided to reignite the series, if that makes any sense at all. And I'm going to start making more videos on some of my train show stuff. So this is all mostly brand new rolling stock that I got at a train show for $40. And it was such an awesome train show. I got so much nice stuff, including the buildings and other stuff. It just really looks nice. I highly suggest you check out that series if you haven't seen it yet. And I really hope you enjoy it. And also over here, we've got a brand new industry. I've expanded the track a little bit because I've had some extra track pieces to work on this industry. And it fits right in with the city. I've got this building temporarily here, a nice freight house. Also got Diesel Deuce here. That was funny. I got that a long time ago. I was going to make a video on that, but I just didn't really think it was worth it. So yeah, if you do see this in my updates a lot, I'm going to have them down here all the time. It's just some old internet meme. That was really funny. Dude's still making videos. It's like classic YouTube stuff. It's awesome. So I've just gone ahead. I bought one myself. A lot of my friends have bought one. One of my friends actually painted it into her fictional railroad livery and brought it to Saginaw. It's like such an awesome event there. It's just one of those little things that remind you of classic YouTube. It's so awesome. And speaking of classic YouTube, we'll get to these in a second. You may recognize this Lego minifigure right here from the How to Sort Out Trespassers series. Well, I'm bringing the series back. Well, I don't know if you could call it a series or not, but I'm doing a 2022 remake of How to Sort Out Trespassers because it's just something that reminds you of classic YouTube, like those little silly series that you would see on like the internet. It's just old YouTube stuff. Like, that is a spoiler for the series. I'm not going to spoil anything about it because it's just one of those things that you have to see to believe it. So yeah, that's a hint at some of the upcoming videos on the channel. And that will be coming soon. So yeah, that is pretty much it for some of the stuff that have changed on the layout. I have added grass to here and I've blown some ballast into here accidentally. I am going to be redoing some of the terrain over here eventually because you can see it's like crusting up, and I used scenic cement. And what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to scenic cement grass and add Mod Podge for the, a watered down Mod Podge for the ballast, because over here, you can see it's just crusting away, and scenic cement doesn't really do its thing. I probably just didn't add that much, but I will try again, and I really don't mind right now because I'm not really showing anyone the layout besides my friends, so it's fine. Now, you may notice this over here. I actually bought a Atherin Hustler locomotive that wasn't operational. I've got everything on this flatbed that it needs replacing. You can see that these wheels are very, very rusted and old. And the motor does not work. And what I'm actually just going to do is I specifically bought this model for the shell, the red one, because all the working ones are this ugly yellow and red one that I just don't like. So I'm going to shell swap it. And until I get another Hustler that's operational, I've just gone ahead and put it on this UP flatbed. I actually had to replace the brake wheel on it because the original one broke. But that is this. I'm going to go ahead and actually show you two new locomotives that are visiting the layout right now. Now, you may not recognize these two locomotives here. That's because they are actually brand new. My friend, the Texas Rail Fan, you should subscribe to him. He makes very nice videos. He actually gave these to me. He lent them to me to run on the layout for a bit. And you've got a Proto 2000 SD60 Union Pacific We Will Deliver right here. and what I believe to be an Athern Blue Box FP45 in custom weathered in the Santa Fe paint scheme. And a lot of my Athern Blue Box stuff like groans when it runs at like full throttle, but this thing is, it's quiet. It's amazing. He did a really good job lubricating this because it's just super quiet and it runs like an Athern Genesis model. Now, he actually requested that he wanted to see these running on my layout, so I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. As you can see, there isn't really much to the layout for Christmas. I haven't been able to do much because I don't really have that much. You have this static display diesel right here that I got from one of my friends, Ari, that I just laid that down there. It's not really anything too big, but yeah, let's go ahead and get right into that running session. Here we go. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I do apologize if this layout update was a little bit lackluster. I didn't really have that much to show, but I did still get a lot done, and I hope you enjoyed. That will probably change by Christmas, because I did have a big Christmas list for some HO scale stuff, so maybe that will improve this layout a lot, because, you know, that's just how progression works. And you've also got the How to Sort Out Trespassers series coming out this Christmas Eve. Hope you're excited, and I'll see you guys later. See ya!